Welcome friends. Today's chapter is Being Human and Spiritual at the Same Time. It has been a million-dollar question for millions of years of human existence whether we are human beings trying to be spiritual or spiritual beings trying to be human. It sounds great, but good enough to confuse. However, being selfish, self-oriented, and self-justifying human beings, we behave humanly whenever we succeed and become spiritual whenever we fail. They say success has many fathers, whereas failure is always in search of one. We always claim the success as an outcome of self-abilities, whereas we blame some supernatural power out up there somewhere responsible for all our failures, and we become spiritual to justify the failures. Success makes us arrogant humans, and failure forces us to be on search of a spiritual guru as solace for debacles in our life. Let us redefine human. H, helpful, humble, hardworking. U, unique, utilitarian. M, mobility, meaningfulness. A, agile, approachable, appreciative. N, nimble, noble, nice, novice. Let us redefine spiritual. S, soul, spirit. P, patience, politeness, passion. I, integrity, ingenuity. R, respect, rejoice. I, intelligence, intensity. T, tolerance, tenacity, temperament. U, ubiquity, universality. A, ambition, attitude. L, love. There are two types of gurus in our life, whom we report day in, day out, week after week, until the end of life. Monday to Friday, practical guru. He says every now and then, with great authority, "Son, you are responsible for your own life, as well as success and failure. You are source of your own happiness and sorrow, and you are in control of your life. Do not blame others for your deeds and accept responsibility of your gains and loss." Whereas Saturday Sunday spiritual guru says, "Son, do not worry. Do your job best and leave rest in caring hands of God Almighty. He will take care of everything. Do not blame yourself for debacles of your life. Have peace with yourself." We live our whole life in state of confusion, which guru to follow and preach. Rather, believe in God, believe in yourselves. God helps them who helps themselves. Help God to help you, but first, please help yourself for the sake of God. Do not sit expecting God to act. Maybe He is sitting expecting you to act. To sweat with bodily hard work, with perseverance, is human, and to wait tenaciously with tolerant mind until get results of our hard work is spiritual. Right balance of humanly behavior with spiritual bend of mind proves to be beneficial. Have belief in God and religion, or belief in goal and mission, faith in fate and luck, or faith in courage and pluck. Swami Vivekananda said, "You cannot believe in God until you believe in yourself." Vince Lombardi said, "Leadership is being based on spiritual quality, the power to inspire, the power to inspire others to follow." Brigitta said, "A leader is a mix of visionary and left brainer. an inspiration to others, who uplifts one to walk beside him, not behind him. A leader lets go of his or her ego and taps into his soul, consistently stretching himself, challenging himself, growing within. Plato said, "A hero is born among 100, a wise man is found among 1,000, but an accomplished one might not be even among 100,000 men." Jay Krishnamurti said, "The great cathedral, the great things of life, the great sculpture must be anonymous. They do not belong to any particular person like truth. Truth does not belong to you or to me. It is totally impersonal and anonymous." Mahatma Gandhi said, "Don't lose faith in humanity. Humanity is an ocean. If a few drops of ocean are dirty, the ocean does not become dirty." The best way to find yourself is to lose yourself in the service of others. Michael Hazelbeck said, "You don't have to have permanent opinions. You can think every morning, 'I love the world,' and go to bed every night thinking, 'I hate the world.'" Saint Augustine said, "Pray as though everything depends on God. Work as though everything depends on you." Deepak Chopra said, "Enlightened leadership is spiritual if we understand spirituality not as some kind of religious dogma or ideology, but as the domain of awareness where we experience values like truth, goodness, beauty, love, and compassion, and also intuition, creativity, insight, and focused attention."